Chapter 24. The railroad station is packed with people, bundles, sacks, cartons, neatly tied packages all around us. A whole city is leaving on a mass pilgrimage. Where to? Where are we all going? What is the name of this place? Does anyone know? Please stay together, Motel urges us. Let's not lose one another in this crowd. Children, my dear children, hold on to one another, please, Mrs. Borowitch. We must stay together, children, we must. On the tracks, freight trains are waiting. They are cattle cars. Why cattle cars? Someone asked, full of panic. We will suffocate in there from the heat. It's mid-August. The heat will kill us. What did you expect? I hear another voice. You thought they would send us first class? To them we are animals, one voice cuts in sarcastically. Besides, they want to make sure that these animals cannot escape. They need our hands to make them uniforms. They need our skilled labor. Still, keep quiet. Do not push. You will all get into the wagons. We have plenty of trains for you, call the guards. I look around me, search for familiar faces. We wave goodbye to people we know. They wave back. Eyes meet, petrified, aghast. What choice do we have? What can we do other than go into the cattle cars? We have no way out, no choice. People all around me, desperately trying to find an answer, clinging to tiny sparks of hope, optimistically spreading rumors. They stop the deportation. The Russian front is too close. They are sending us back home. They need us. They will not hurt us as long as they need our labor. But the trains keep filling up with people. Each wagon is locked. One train pulls away, and another pulls up, ready to be loaded. We wait our turn, holding up to one another. Next, hurry up. Get your bundles. Move, move. Get into the wagons. You there, hurry, you stupid Jews. They are calling our group. Panic seizes me. This is it. We are going into the cattle cars for a journey to the unknown. The guards are getting very impatient. They are already bored with the game of loading Jews into the wagons. They are angrier and louder now. Jew, make it faster. Leibish is helping his mother up into the wagon. She slips. He pulls her quickly into the wagon before the whip of the angry Nazi can touch her body. You cursed old Jew, the Nazi guard shouts, swinging his whip in all directions. We move fast, trying to duck the whip. So many families are being separated. We must try to stay together. We must try. We are at the end of the line. The train is almost full. Whatever happens, please let us stay together, I pray silently. Please, just let us be together. Someone reaches out to help me into the cattle car. Motel and Moshel are behind me, lifting me up. They jump in after me. Are we all here? I call out to Leibish. Yes, yes. We all made it into the same wagon. There is Carola, Beryl, Mrs. Makita, my mother, and my sister. He points to the corner of the car. Let's try to make our way toward them. We squeeze through the crowded wagon. We sit down on the floor, worn out from the horrible ordeal, but relieved to be all together again. We can hardly move our arms. We are just like one big mass of tired flesh, hot and steaming. The doors are about to close. I hear someone scream. I am part of a family. Don't leave me behind. Here, stay with your family. I hear a sarcastic remark in German, and someone is pushed into the wagon. The doors close. We are all in total darkness. Some cry out hysterically, others pray aloud. Slowly my eyes penetrate the darkness. From some cracks in the walls, rays of light break through, throwing ghastly shadows on our terrified faces. Is this what a grave feels like? Someone wonders aloud. In a grave you have more room than this, a sobbing voice answers. We must have hope. We must not give up hope, I hear a voice from the other end of the wagon. Remember, all the Hamans who tried to destroy our people, we survived. God will not abandon us now. He will not forsake us. Hope, people, hope. Oh, he's lost his mind completely, someone responds. I cannot see any faces. They are all covered in darkness. I see only shadows around me, but the voices are clear, painfully clear. So where is God? Why does he not answer us? Have we not suffered enough? What is he waiting for? You are sinning with that kind of talk. We must pray. Pray. Maybe I have sinned, but what about my little children? What sins can little children commit? They were only babies. So why did they take them from us? Why did God allow that to happen? Bitter voices, angry, heartbroken, wailing. We sit huddled together, listening to the voices around us. Mrs. Borowitch puts her head on her daughter's lap, mumbling something to herself. Rifkel caresses her mother's head, whispering, "It's all right, Mama." Riva? Motel turns toward me, taking my hands in his. His voice sounds so strained. Riva, they may separate us. They may separate the men from the woman. Remember, if this happens, stay with Carola and Rifkel. You must look out for one another. You must be strong. We must live. We must survive. I'll take care of Moshel, I promise. Leibish, Beryl, and I are the older boys. We'll keep Moshel between us so he'll look older than 13. We'll take care of Moshel, I promise you. I pull them both close to me. We cry silently together. Mrs. Borowitz raises her head from her daughter's lap. I will watch over my children. I will watch over my children. She says with sudden determination, don't worry, my children, don't worry. Milchel turns suddenly toward Rifko. He puts his hand on Rifko's shoulder. Rifko, please take care of my sister, he says. You are the oldest of the girls here. You are their big sister. Riva is not very strong. She always had us to watch over her. We are leaving her in your hands. Please look after her. I will, Milchel, I will, she whispers softly. Days turn to nights and nights into days again. The cracks in the walls let some rays of sunlight to tell us that it is a new day. The rays of moonlight come through the cracks to let us know it is night again. We doze, resting our heads on one another's shoulders, awake and startled by nightmares to find that nightmares are real. The stench of human secretion mixed with the sweltering heat makes it hard to breathe. The buckets used as toilets are overflowing. People faint from the smell, from heat, from exhaustion. The train stops several times, but no doors are open. How much longer? How much more can we endure? Hold on. Do not give up. We will survive. Voices of strangers trying to comfort one another, searching for the courage to stay alive. It has been 3 long, horrible days and 3 terrifying nights. Where are we going? Where are we going? The train stops. The doors finally open. The sudden sunlight is blinding, but our ears are filled with music. Music all around us. Where are we? What is this place? Welcome to Auschwitz, Jews. A German voice comes through the loudspeaker. Welcome to Auschwitz, Jews. The living crawl out. The dead are pulled out.